Hello, my name is Rainer Hanekamp. This is ng-news with the latest updates from the Angular community every week. Ng-Conf happened in Maryland and the keynote was live streamed and is publicly available. Minko Getchev and Mark Thompson from the Angular team did the keynote. Mark Thompson is now becoming the new DevRel lead and follows Minko, whereas Minko has now become the tech lead of Google's frameworks. Mark explained that the upcoming Angular aria wants to be a headless Angular material, Angular CDK. It provides all accessibility features with directives, but without the layout. So the styling is completely up to us.
Angular Aria is a library of headless directives for common accessibility patterns. We have a list box of directive applied to a div, and then inside for one of the values, we have the ng option. Behind the scenes, we take care of the rest to set it up to make it accessible for you. Now, at launch, this is the list that we have right now, but more may be coming.
Minko continued by sharing his vision of what future AI support for Angular could look like. He said that FDLM has access to the browser.
And the most powerful thing about it is that this agent has access to every single component instance in your application, all the runtime data. It can also see your routing tree, and it can see your injector tree with all your services and all their internal states.
Which would allow it to write specific tests, but also help much, much more in bug fixing. Alejandro Cuba Ruiz published a four-part series on performance. His final article focuses on the bundle optimization. He doesn't just discuss basic settings in the Angular JSON, but also how to tweak the build in terms of browser support, how to choose third-party libraries, and how to analyze the final bundle. At the end, he also writes about the Angular DevTools and other tools like Crux or PageSpeed, which can help us to monitor real-world performance. His article is also available in Spanish. If workshops are recorded, then they are usually behind a paywall, but not this one. The testing workshop that Younes Jaaidi gave at ViteConf is available for free if you register. It lasts about 2 hours 15 minutes and covers practical testing strategies in depth. Tim Deschryver, the author of one of the most important articles about using template-driven forms over reactive ones, has now published another article about SignalForms. He's using the latest version where the control directive has been renamed to field. Tim walks through the common features, such as validation, submitting, and nested groups, and shares his personal thoughts in the end. No surprise, but he is now also favoring SignalForms over template-driven ones. And that's it. I wish you a nice week. See you in the next episode. Goodbye.